Personification is a metaphor. It's just a specific kind of metaphor. So it's a device where poets or authors give human-like characteristics to things that are not human. Okay? So it could be an abstract idea, or inanimate objects, or, you know, plants, animals, but it's giving human-like characteristics to them. It is not giving animal-like characteristics to human, okay, or inanimate objects, you know, robotic-like characteristics to human beings. So it works in one direction only, okay? So if we look here, right, at this example, blow, blow, thou winter wind, okay, thou art not so unkind. So the Shakespeare here is saying, you know, he's talking to the wind. In and of itself, that's kind of personifying the wind. And then it says, you are not as unkind as a man's ingratitude when they're ungrateful. So he's telling he's giving the wind the characteristic of not being unkind, okay? So if we look on, thy tooth is not so keen. So here, winds don't actually have teeth, but teeth, we use our teeth to bite, and we often talk about how a wind bites. So that's giving the wind a human-like characteristic to try and describe the feeling of when the wind is stinging your skin. Okay? And then it says here, although thy breath be rude. So again, thy meaning you, talking to the wind, saying that giving the feeling and sensation of the wind blowing, calling it breath. Okay, so that would be a personification, and saying that it's rude. So that would also be personification, because the wind cannot be rude, nor does it have breath. Okay, and again, here the sky doesn't bite, right? And so those would be examples of personification.